part 2 on facts about black mambas. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video. Black mambas often prefer to hunt near water, which attracts plenty of prey. But it also attracts predators that might kill and feed on the black mamba itself. A hungry Nile crocodile will not hesitate to kill the black mamba if given a chance. Yet, it remains unknown if these powerful reptiles are immune to the mamba's neurotoxic venom. Juvenile crocodiles prefer to hunt smaller prey, such as fish, birds, reptiles and mammals. Rats build a stable diet for young Nile crocodiles, in particular near villages and other human settlements. The crocodile attack chases the rodent away from the water and towards the black mamba. A swift bite will kill the rat in minutes, but the commotion won't remain unnoticed. All snakes are extremely vulnerable during feeding, almost unable to defend themselves while devouring its prey whole. The time-consuming ingestion and descent of the cadaver will attract other predators, in particular near water. The black mamba seems to be aware of the present danger and escape just in time before the Nile crocodiles are close enough to attack. Hunting rodents underground is less dangerous for the black mamba. The black mamba's neurotoxic venom will kill the mouse in a few minutes, but feeding on such meager prey begins already before death occurs. Mice are small, and the mamba might continue searching the entire burrow and consume up to 8 rodents during its visit. When finished feeding, the black mamba will not kill other occupants of the same burrow, but it might remember its location and return when hungry again. The most chilling facts are documented in reports on rogue black mambas. Snake expert C.P. Ioannidis wrote in his book Mambas and Man-Eaters that 8 people were killed near Minwara in Source, Tanzania. On March 7, 1954, Ioannidis captured a 10-foot female basking in a tree near the village and sold it to the London Zoo. No further deaths from snake bites have been reported since its capture. Charles Pittman described yet another rogue black mamba incident in his book Snakes of Uganda, in which an aggressive black mamba began chasing after livestock and eventually killing 11 villages in northern Rhodesia within a year. A large black mamba pursued 2 wildlife filmmakers in Tanzania in 2010. The frightened men escaped into their vehicle, and to everyone's surprise, the agitated black mamba even attacked the car to gain entry, before the vehicle drove away. Reports on rogue black mambas are rare, but they do occur occasionally, just like individual king cobras that chase and kill forest workers in Asia while passing through its territory during mating season. Local authority posted warning signs in specific areas to avoid such fatalities. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video. Thank you for watching.